हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम राहुल कुमार प्रजापति एंड यू आर वाचिंग एसएसटी पैराडाइज अचीवर्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ मेजर लैंडफॉर्म्स। आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज माउंटेन। व्हाट आर माउंटेन्स? माउंटेन आर एन अपलिफ्टेड एरिया ऑफ द अर्थ, बट इट हैज शार्प पीक्स। इफ यू सी दिस फिगर, This is sharp peaks. Mountain has sharp peaks. So there are two types of mountain. First one is old mountain and second one is young mountain. Old mountain are those mountain which does not have sharp peaks. It means upper part will be bare down or worn down. Upper part will be worn down by the nature. These mountain will be called old mountain. The example of old mountain are Aravalli mountain. This is found in Rajasthan area. And it's it also goes to the Delhi side. Rajasthan hills are situated on the Aravalli mountain. Okay, and it is in Rajasthan. And Ural Mountain here. If you see the world map, this is the North America, this is South America, this is Europe, and this is Asia, and this is Africa. Okay, so this is Ural Mountain. Ural Mountain divides Europe and Asia. Ural Mountain divides Europe and Asia. And next, Ural Mountain is in Russia, and Appalachian Mountain is in USA, United States of America, here. Okay, so after that, Young Mountain has been formed by the latest geographical features. Has the latest geographical features. And it was formed naturally 25 million years ago. And the example of young mountain are Alps mountain are found in Europe continent. And Andes is found in the here in South America, in the western coast of South America. You can see Antarctic in this mountain. And to the west side, it means here, to the western coast, you can see a range of mountain. This is Rockies Mountain. Okay, these are the example of Jan Mountain. And here you can see a range of mountain. Three ranges of mountain can be seen here. Here you can see first range of mountain. This is Great Himalayan. And you can see here second range of mountain. This is Middle Himalayan. And this is Shivali Himalaya. These are three ranges of mountain. These are the example of young mountains. Okay, it is spread from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, this is the series of mountain. Okay, like that. Okay, after that our next topic is plateaus. What are plateaus? Plateaus are an uplifted area. It is an uplifted area of the earth, but it does not have sharp peaks. It has rugged surface, like this. This is rugged surface, and this is plain surface. Okay, so it has rugged surface. Plateau has rugged surface. It is just like a tableland. Its average height is 600 meters. Its average height is 600 meter, and the plateau of Tibet, which means Tibet ka pathar, plateau of Tibet is called the roof of the world, sansar ki chhat. The plateau of Tibet is called roof of the world, and these plateaus are the storehouse of minerals like iron ore and coal. Okay. And some of the examples of plateaus Here you are seeing this is the map of India, and here if you talk about this portion of India, this portion. This portion. This is Deccan Valley.
This is
Deccan Valley. Deccan Plateau. This is the area of Deccan Plateau, Arabian Plateau, Brazil Plateau. These are the examples of some plateaus. These are very very famous. Arabian Plateau. Arabian Plateau is to the west side here. Arabian Plateau. Okay. And our next topic is plains. Plains. What are plains? Plains are the flat lands. Flat land on which we live. We can grow crops on the flat land. Flat land has been formed by the rivers. Here, ranges of mountain and mountain rivers come from the mountain. You can see a lot of rivers. Here you can see Ganga, Yamuna, Gandak, Ghaggar, Chambal, Vedva, Sun, like that. This forms the Ganga river system, you know. And Northern plains are formed by the Ganga river system. Okay, Ganga is the main river of our country. At the average height of the plains, is 100 meter. And Northern Plain, Chinese Plain and Egyptian Plain are the some examples of plains. Okay. Our next topic is atmosphere. Atmosphere is the sphere of air where we can find a lot of gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen and helium, hydrogen, like that. There are many gases present in our atmosphere and they are very essential for our life. And if you talk about nitrogen is available 78%, oxygen is available 21%. These two main gases constitute 99% of the total air. And only the amount of carbon dioxide is 0.03. It is very essential for our life because without carbon dioxide, our earth will be just like a snowball. And nitrogen is 78%, and it has a great economic importance because if there is no carbon dioxide, there will be a problem to that. Listen firstly. Nitrogen is available 78%. The work of nitrogen dilutes oxygen. That's why something cannot burn rapidly. Okay, this is the main work of nitrogen, and the roots of the plant take this nitrogen. Okay, and the plants take it by converting to nitrate. And oxygen is a very important gas because we are getting oxygen. Without oxygen, we can't survive. Human beings taking oxygen from our atmosphere, and when we are inhaling, we are taking oxygen, and when we are exhaling, we are releasing carbon dioxide. Okay. Argon, helium and hydrogen, these are other gases. And you should also know about ozone layer. Suppose that this is our earth, and ozone layer is covered our earth. When the sun rays come, the ultraviolet rays is absorbed by this ozone layer. If there is no ozone layer, there will be a problem of skin disease. Human beings will be affected. Okay? This is the cause of skin diseases. Okay? Now your topics have been finished. थैंक यू।